These folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the Dallas Cowboys and the Houston Gunners. Both of these teams about to reach the halfway point of this NFL season, and we're underway on EA Sports.
Fields it in the middle of the end zone. And no run back here, so they'll bring it out to the 25.
They'll run on first down. Croner. And right away they're going to stack him up right at the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain on the game's first play. And it's second down now.
Defensively, we always know that he is tough in run support. And I think the way that he gets there is he understands what an offense is going to do before the ball's even snapped. A great job of scouting prior to the game, then reading, reacting, and taking the right path to the ball carrier.
Second down, long. That's complete to John Ross. And they're able to get this one across the 35. It's a first down on a gain of 10. That's what we're used to seeing from him right there. Plays like that, why he's number 4 in the league in terms of receiving yardage.
Able to make adjustments all along the way. Doesn't matter where he lines up, where he releases from. Working his way into the secondary. Figures out defenses and finds weak spots in order to get open.
On first down, Crowder. And he puts his head down and gets up to the 42 for a gain of about 6.
Defensively here, you're facing a top 5 team in terms of points scored in the NFL. So when they're that high power, you've got to find a way to hold them under 20. Because to me, that's the magic number. 20 points scored, give yourself your best chance to win.
So if they're up around 24, 28, 30, they could be in some trouble.
I think so, because then you turn it into a shootout. And that means your offense has to keep pace.
The last run got 6. Now second and 4. The first carry now for Dalvin Cook. Oh, he's got some breathing room. And he works free. And he's into the clear. Touchdown, Houston. Dalvin Cook with touchdown number 12 on the year. And his guys have taken a first quarter lead.
Bottom line, when you play a runner with these talents, you've got to be able to wrap up and get him on the ground. Or the first person who gets there, hold him up long enough for the next wave to get there and get him down. Otherwise, he will continue downfield and find pay dirt.
Rosas good with the extra point. And it's now a 7-0 game. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. Taken at the 15, a short kick. Lane opens here. He's past the 30.
First and 10. That will be at their own 33-yard line.
So Prescott of the Cowboys now with a 1st and 10 at the 33-yard line. Now the first carry for Ezekiel Elliott. And he'll work this one up to about the 38. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's 2nd and 4.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent gain.
6 yards on that last play. Here's second and four. Here's Elliott. And he'll go down right around the 47 this time. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down. Now, look, that wasn't a huge gain, but those are the types of carries I think they were missing in their loss last week. They couldn't get him going on the ground.
Did you get the same feeling I did during our meetings, that they kind of regretted that he didn't touch the
Absolutely.
Ball? Absolutely. You know, hey, he should have touched it more last week. They weren't going to make that same mistake, and they've taken care of that early.
So after a good run by Zeke, another first and 10. From the gun, they'll try to run it. And they'll work this down to the 40-yard line. Tackled there. 13 yards and a first down, Cowboys.
How many times do we say in this game is speed kills? And it does it in so many different ways. In this case, you got a back who's quick and shifty, can make moves, make people miss, but also gets to and through a hole before it can close down. That's some of the benefits of that speed, not just outrunning people in the secondary, and that led to a really nice gain.
So a first and 10 now in Houston territory, right at the 40. This is Elliott. And give him 6 yards here as he stopped near the 35 at the 34.
All right, Brandon, I know we're in the early going here, but those kind of runs, they're going to open up a world of opportunities for this offense going forward.
Second down, it's Pollard. And he'll get a little over two, maybe a full three down to the 32-yard line.
That's all about doing the dirty work right there defensively. Second and short yardage, that's all about plugging those gaps, not giving a running back a crease to run through, and has a nice job to hold him just a couple and force a third down.
They'll try and run for it with Elliott. And he's going to have the first down yardage as he's down at about the 30-yard line. 2 yards and able to get the first down in the process.
First down, Cowboys.
On this drive so far. It's first and 10. They'll run with Pollard. Might have gotten this one down to the 28, and that's all. Grady Jarrett with the tackle.
Well, sometimes you just have to give credit to the defense. Great job there at the point of attack, holding up. They won their battles at the line of scrimmage, left him no space to try and run. A really nice job swarming to the ball carrier.
Here's second and 9, just a yard on that last run. Now a shotgun handoff to Pollard. And he'll be brought down at about the 25 after a pickup of 4.
But if you're going to have a relay race, you're probably going to pick your backs and receivers to run it, but don't underestimate the conditioning of the offensive line. They're out there just dictating things, staying on the field, and keeping a long drive going.
And on third and 5, this will be the 8th play of the drive.
And he picks up the first down yardage as he takes this one down to the 15. Bit of a surprise. They ran it on third and medium. Proved to be the right call. First and 10. After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's first and 10. They keep on the ground with Elliott. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. Ezekiel Elliott, his fourth touchdown on the year. And the Cowboys are an extra point away from tying the football game. Now Greg Zuerlein on for the extra point. It's up and good, and we're tied at 7 here in quarter number 2.
Ties the game at 7.
Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. Offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. After the long touchdown drive we just saw, you wonder if maybe that's taken a little of the wind out of this offensive sails, because they had it going pretty good last time, too.
Had to sit over there for a little while, didn't they? You know, they were eager, amped up to get back on the field after just scoring, hoping to get the ball back quickly. That didn't happen, so I'd say come out, just kind of get started again. You know, it doesn't have to be anything dramatic. Just get moving, get loose again, and see if they can get it downfield.
First down, Love to pass. And a 5-yard gain gets him to the 42.
Brandon, perfect defense in this situation would have meant that there was an incompletion. They would have picked it off. Okay, so they gave up the completion. But I really enjoyed watching how the defense stayed in sync, stayed in great communication. And as he dragged across each zone, you see him pointing, communicating. There he is, and they passed him off to each defender. Ended up making a nice play, even though it was complete.
Second and 5 after the 5-yard completion on first down. Working out of the gun. Love slings this deep from McLaurin. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
Nice play there to force the incompletion. And to me, one thing's for sure. When you're the underdogs and you're playing on the road, you absolutely have to get takeaways. You've got to get the ball from them.
Yeah, win that turnover battle, going to be key. They didn't get one there, but you get the feeling they keep making plays like that, they might just get a few.
Yeah, once you get one, defensive teams think they come in bunches.
That's complete to Mostert out of the backfield. And he gets us to the other side of midfield across the 35 before going out. They get 14 on that one. Good for a Houston first down. So from Cowboy territory now, here's first and 10 at the 44-yard line. On the ground, it's Cook. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. It's a 6-yard pickup, but it gets him to second and 4. Another good run there for a guy who, remember, on Wednesday was named NFC Offensive Player of the Week for what he did a week ago.
Yeah, and you know it takes some solid runs and some extra special ones in order to win that type of an award. I think he's locked in and wants to get it done a second time.
And he got half of what he needed there, 2 yards, and it'll bring up a 3rd and 2 more.
A gain of 2 brings up 3rd and 2.
Here's Cook. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. We've seen him break off a big run already in this game, and for a second, that one looked like it might be another.
Yeah, I think that any defense would say, look, we can't let him get to the second level, because sometimes he'll break off the big run on his own, but oftentimes you get additional blocking at the second level, which gets you deeper into the secondary.
Love now to pass on first down. Looking for McLaurin, and he's got him. And down inside the 15 he goes. Same exact result as last play, a pickup of 11.
How about a guy proving his worth in different ways? Had the big play in the run game the play before. This time, they go right back to him in the passing game, and he comes through with yet another big play. That's why you work out so hard in the offseason, so you can stay on the field and accumulate big plays.
First down, here's the run with Cook. And he'll be taken down here at about the 11. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
I know the scouting report on him is that he doesn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker. And what that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play. But on that one, he looked like one of those guys.
Now a second down throw for Love here. And incomplete. He tried to leave it underneath. Nearly got picked. They may be lucky to have that one back. Third down.
Certainly appeared to take away his first read, and by the time he tried to look elsewhere and find an open target, the coverage was too good. That one falls incomplete.
In search of 8 yards on third down. They've already converted two of these on this drive, 2 for 2. Shotgun, it's Love. His throw caught right around the 6. And boy, he is very close to a first down, but from where they're spotting that football, he's going to be a foot or so short.
And less than a yard.
The offense here not budging. They're going to fight for it on 4th and inches. Running for it. Here's Cook. And he gets into the end zone. Touchdown, Houston. Dalvin Cook with his 13th touchdown of the year and 2nd of the game. And his guys have taken the lead. And he's got it. It's now a 14-7 ball game. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And they had to wait a long time to get the football back. Probably not what you were hoping for when you got an offense that's humming.
Agreed. What you were looking for is the defense get the ball back pretty quickly, right? Hoping for a 3 and out. So that didn't happen. You can't yell at your D for that. They've got to take care of their own business and reestablish themselves now that they're back on the field.
Give him 10 yards there, and about by the nose of the football, he's going to have a first down.
First down.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on 1st and 10. Here's Pollard. And this defense not giving him anything there. Maybe a yard up to the 36.
Ladies and gentlemen, that is a force of nature at the defensive tackle position. Yes, he's as big as they come, but still plenty agile. He's able to make a nice play there to swallow up the ball carrier.
We've hit the two-minute mark of the second quarter, 14-7. Coming up in a couple of minutes, we'll get you to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. The coach will have stats and scores from earlier today in the NFL. On second down, Pollard. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. Now the defense going to use the first of their timeouts. So as they take it over, we step aside. Third down, it's Prescott. Trying to lay one up deep. Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. Adrian Amos with a pick. And his guys are going to take over at the 31-yard line.
Well, I tell you, Brandon, this ball's intercepted, but it is third down. So the silver lining is that since this is so far down the field and there wasn't a big run back associated with it, really this kind of works like a punt. It's not an altogether bad result.
The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. And right now they're saying, hey, let's keep this going. Two drives, two touchdowns.
Yeah, can't ask for a better start than that, can you? I mean, this is the way you practice it. This is the way you rehearse it. But right now, the play calling, they're locked in really well.
There he goes, right side. Touchdown, Houston. Dalvin Cook on his way to a monster game. Three first-half touchdowns. And his guys get the quick strike touchdown. It's good, and it is now 21-7. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. A fairly short kick from the 14. Now a crease here as he's past the 30. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. A tale of two extremes already in this game. A touchdown pass on their opening drive followed by an interception last time out.
Now, it sounds like things balance out, right? What's that mythological thing that we do? If you have a candy bar, have a diet soda with it, it balances it out. And we know that's not really true, right? Because the interception, that sting lingers a little bit longer. Got to come out now and put together some nice plays.
First and 10, Prescott. Throwing the out route incomplete. It's Elliott. Call it no gain there on the first down play.
Well, that was a simple throw and catch, but even with that completion, 0 yards gained, so they're behind schedule on down and distance.
I think they were hoping to get it to him. He can make a man or two miss, but that window closed quickly. Had the completed pass, but for no gain, stopped right at the line, so it's second and 10. From the shotgun, it's Prescott. He'll find Lamb. That's complete. Now a second timeout called for by the defense as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. The last
pass play on the completion got them half of what they needed. Now here's a tough third and five. Prescott now from the 50. And he's going to find his man out of the backfield. That's complete. Yeah, he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. 13 yards and a first down, Cowboys.
First down, Cowboys.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. Prescott yet again. His throw incomplete. CeeDee Lamb is intended target. And now it's second down.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
They'll try again from the 36 on second and 10. Gun. It's Elliott. And the play goes nowhere. Losing yardage back near the 40 at the 39. Now the Cowboys going to burn the first of their timeouts as they get it right at the 32nd mark of this first half. For Prescott. Looking left side and he's got a man. It's Elliott. And this play going to be stopped in its tracks at the 32 and obviously well short of the first down. Now the defense will burn their third and final timeout as they stop it with 19 seconds to go in half number one. Cowboys trot out Greg Zuerlein. It'll be a 49-yard attempt from the left hash. And Zuerlein's kick is good. And that will get the disadvantage now back down to 11. So the 3 points here, they're still down, but they put somewhat of a dent into that lead going into the break.
Anything helps when you're trying to chip away at a lead, but they do know that they're going to need a little bit better effort in the second half.
So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how.
And a double team, it's intercepted. Anthony Brown. And his guys have got it back at the closing stages of the first half.
At their own 13-yard line.
From the 13 now, they work on first and 10. And they'll indeed start on the ground to run that clock. And he'll just push his way forward for a few as the clock will run. So we've reached halftime here on Halloween. And trust me, kids, if you had to look at Charles Davis every game, you'd think every day was Halloween. As we send you on over to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman in our EA Sports Halftime Report. Take it away, Coach. It's the Cowboys who get the football first, and they trail here as well as we resume action in the third quarter. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. Yeah. Second half starts with a carry by Elliott. And he's going to be dropped following a pickup of 7 past the 30 to the 32.
But no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
Yards to go on second down, and they've got three tight ends out there. Jumbo set. Run for Pollard. And he'll get this up only to about the 33. And they got half of what he needed there, 2 yards, and it'll bring up a 3rd and 2 more.
Sometimes with the running game, you've just got to stick with it. Look, it's the 3rd quarter, no time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays, but stay with the overall essence of the running game.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on 3rd down. Now Elliott, and he will have a 1st down as they get him to the ground at the 37. A 3rd down gain of 3 yards, and that'll be enough. Well, after an interception, last thing you want to do is go 3 and out, give the ball right back. They avoided that.
Yeah, you definitely do not want to do that. I remember in college I played with a really big-time player on defense. We ended up getting an interception as we passed the offense coming out. He told him, if you don't take care of this football, you have to answer to me later. You definitely want to take care of it, pick up 1st downs.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on 1st and 10. Quickly there. He gets maybe a couple up to the 38.
Looks like they're establishing a pretty good pattern here because they've been very heavy in the running game on the last 4 plays.
Yeah, you took the words right out of my mouth. So far, 4 plays in this drive, all 4 on the ground. The last run good for 2. Here's 2nd and 8. They'll try to throw now. Prescott. And he's got his man out of the backfield. That's complete. Call it a 3-yard gain. And all of a sudden here, it's 3rd down.
That might feel like a little bit of a lost opportunity there for the offense because the defense brought pressure that time. And sometimes against that, you can get it out to your running back and it could turn into a big gain downfield. But what a nice job they did getting to him quickly and holding him to a short gain.
And on 3rd down, a nickel formation here defensively. Out of the gun, here's Prescott. And he's got his man in stride, complete. And he's out of bounds just before the midfield stripe at the 49. He was held without a catch in the 1st half, but he's got one here, and he also picks up a 1st down. 2 1st downs have him up near midfield now on 1st and 10. Now back to the ground with Elliott. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage on the play back at the 46. That'll set him back with a loss of 3 on the play. And it'll bring up a 2nd and 13. Prescott from the gun.
Got an open man, the tight end Jarwin. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Prescott. Cooper's got him. And past the 35, he'll be dropped a yard or two shy of the 30. 17 yards on the play there, and the Cowboys have a first down.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Here's Elliott. And he's going to get this one down to the 30. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9.
You know that old expression, it's not my night? It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
And every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play. The run only got a yard. Here's second and 9. Throwing. Prescott. And he's got Cooper on the out route. That's complete. And they'll work it inside the 15-yard line before it's all said and done. 16 yards, a first down. Here's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line. Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down.
First downs have not come easy, and neither have runs like this throughout this game.
Absolutely not. He finally felt like, whoa, a sigh of relief. We got something going in the running game. They'll try to run it in with Elliott, and he'll get in. Touchdown, Cowboys. Ezekiel Elliott with his second touchdown of the game and fifth on the year. And the Cowboys draw a bit closer. So Dak will bring the Cowboys up to go for the two-point try. Off play action to Elliott. Here's Prescott. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked by Kendall Fuller. Weaving through traffic, and now he's free. The 20, 10, 5, and he takes it all the way back. It's a pick two, if you will, as that play backfires in a big way. This game back within a touchdown now as the kickoff's away. Offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. Pretty important third quarter drive for them. Momentum has sort of shifted the other direction after that last touchdown as they nurse this small lead. And all the way down to the 27. A big play there out of Cook. 48 yards on the ground.
First and 10 in the 27-yard line.
So from Cowboy territory now, here's first and 10 at the 27. Back now here on EA Sports. As we've got the final quarter upon us, we get ready to start the fourth. On first and 10, Love. His throw is going to be incomplete. He was looking for John Ross that time, but it's going to be second down. Charles, you'd said the magic number was probably right around 20 for this defense because they're facing one of the top five offenses in the league in terms of points scored. They've had their moments, but this offense, just a little too good, isn't it?
They really are, because no matter what you do to make an adjustment on defense, they've had an answer for it.
On second down now, it's Cook. They do get a couple, but they'll be left staring at a third and 8 coming up.
Brandon, we talk all the time about those hybrid players, guys who could do more than one thing. And I think if you're playing strong safety in the NFL today, you are a true hybrid. Part linebacker, part cover guy.
And coming up, sticking his nose in the mess there and making a nice play defensively. In need of a conversion on third down. They had the big play to start the drive. Not much sense. Now Love. Got a man. It's Ross. Complete. And he'll go out of bounds inside the 15-yard line. And a gain there of 11 yards.
Now that's a big pickup right there. And so often we focus on how the quarterback's faking out play action. How about everyone being in on the deal and picking it up?
Second, third levels, you could see them trying to recover. They bit. Worked out offensively. Here's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line. A 10th carry in the game for Cook. And he's in. Touchdown, Houston. 14 yards. And his guys find a way to stretch that lead. And that rushing touchdown is fourth, puts him just one shy of the NFL record in a single game.
And we all know he would love to get to that record and even beyond it, but he doesn't need to in order to impress in this one, does he? What a performance. What an absolute great game that he's had here in this one.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked. But you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
Give them 13 yards on the opening play of the drive and also give them a first down.
First down, Dallas.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. The This is Elliott. And he's going to be stopped up quickly here. Just a yard up to the 39.
Yeah, things were pretty stacked up there in the middle of the line. A lot of bodies, not much space. I think ultimately he was fortunate to get anything out of that run.
Second and nine. Prescott, and he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
It certainly didn't appear that that's where he wanted to go with the ball initially, so he tried to get something out of it by dumping it off to his running back unsuccessfully.
The Cowboys on third down. They've hit on six of their eight tries. Very good. This is third and nine. Here's Prescott. And he comes back with one complete. And he'll be taken down across the 50 at the 45 in enemy territory. It's a gain of 16 and a Dallas first down. So a first and 10 now in Houston territory at the 45-yard line. Now Prescott. To the right side, he's got Cooper. It's complete. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. Give him nine there on the first down completion.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you've got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go because he might wander into some tough coverage.
That last catch short of the marker by just a yard leaves him with a very manageable second and one. They'll run with Pollard. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. 12 yards there and a first down.
We'll definitely see some open running lanes, and he's taking advantage of it right now, but that shouldn't be a surprise. Defense has the lead. They're playing for the pass first.
First down, Prescott. Letting one go deep for the end zone. And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. From the 24, they'll go again on second and 10. Another carry tonight for the workhorse Elliott. And not much. Maybe a yard down to the 23.
Not too many offenses want to turn down long drives, but when you're down what they are, they've got to pay it off with some points.
The Cowboys on third down. Can't fault these numbers. 7 for 9 thus far. This is third and nine. Prescott now. He's going to find his running back. It's complete. And he will reach the 5-yard line before going out of bounds. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. Clock management, definitely critical here if they want to get back in this game.
Absolutely agreed. They have to up the tempo in this case, down a couple of scores. Want to make sure they have a chance to win this ball game.
First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. Here's Prescott. He'll set up the screen to Elliott. And he's going to be taken down right at the line. No gain on the screen there. It's second down. So nothing there on the screen that time.
That means all that great acting they tried on offense went for naught, didn't it? Because you have to try and influence them. Make them think that you're doing something else. Make them think that they can get to the passer by letting them by and then setting up the screen and getting downfield. Didn't happen at all. Give a lot of credit to the defense for not tumbling to that one.
They get 3 yards closer, but still work to do. It's third and goal. Two minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So the Cowboys in possession of the football here as we get you reset. They've got a third and goal now as they try to punch in a late touchdown. Here's Elliott, and he will take it in for a Cowboys goal. Taking it in from 2 yards out, and the Cowboys have cut it to within a score.
I'm not sure win-win is the proper term here, but it certainly felt like it. They got the touchdown they needed, but if I'm on the defensive side of the ball, okay, you got the touchdown, but it sure took you a long time.
Yeah, because offensively there, you're probably hoping for a 1-5 play drive. That one ate up a little more time than they were hoping.
You're exactly right, and if you have that 1-5 play drive, you actually build up momentum and even more hope. When they had to slog their way downfield, they got the touchdown, but it's almost like, yeah, you know.
Doesn't feel right.
Exactly.
The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. And this game not quite over yet. And we'll likely see them take all three timeouts defensively, so they can't just kneel this one out. They're going to have to try to run a few plays.
You're exactly right. They've got to get a first down and make them use up all their timeouts in order to feel like they have this one in hand.
Slings this deep from McLaurin. He's got a man complete. He's able to get this to the 40-yard line before he's out of bounds. An excellent gain, 35 yards. So the challenge comes inside of 2 minutes, and it gets overturned.
And it changes the whole format of what's about to happen because both sides had thought a certain call had been made. Now they have to flip back and start over.
Had the completed pass, but for no gain, stopped right at the line, so it's second and 10. Now try and wind down some clock with Clark. And they get this from the 25 to the 30 for a pickup of 5. Now the Cowboys going to burn the first of their timeouts as they'll talk it over here before what will be an important third down. Now Love. He's going to have the hook up to Ross. And they get him down. Before he takes it across the 40-yard line. A good gain of 12 yards that time. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And the second wave of tacklers is going to get him as they stop him behind the line. The Cowboys going to use their second timeout now, as he'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. Second and 11 at the 41. Love looking to throw. And that is
is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down. Charles, thinking back to what you said in the first quarter, that part of the magic elixir for a road victory for these underdogs was going to be winning the turnover battle. Well, they only have one right now. Look at the scoreboard.
Yeah, not exactly playing to the form that I subscribed, right? When you talk about winning that turnover battle, that evens things out, especially for a road team, especially for a team that's an underdog.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense, as he'll talk it over here before what'll be an important third down. Here's Love. Going deep downfield for Ross. And he's in. Touchdown, Houston. John Ross with a lucky number 13 touchdowns now on the year. And his guys are going to add on to their lead. Rosas to add the extra point. And he's been a busy man, 5 for 5 now, as he knocks another one through to extend the lead. Kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go up and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
CeeDee Lamb is intended target, and that'll bring up second down. From the shotgun, a give to Elliott. He'll have a first down past the 40, and he'll finally be taken down just shy of midfield. The Cowboys signal for their third and final timeout as they get it with under a minute to go now in the football game. First down throw for Prescott. And nowhere to fit that football in. It's knocked away and incomplete. Michael Gallup, that's who he was looking for. And it's second down.
And that's a nice job there, because you've got to play the ball, not the man when in coverage. That'll keep you away from a lot of needless penalties. And he's able to knock that one away.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. To throw is Prescott. This one caught left side by Cooper. He'll be taken down at the 48 for a pickup of 2 yards. They do get a couple, but they'll be left staring at a 3rd and 8 coming up.
Third down.
And they're left looking at third and eight after the second down pass play only went for two. From the shotgun, it's Prescott. And he'll have his man. That's Cooper. And he's got the first before he's brought down at the 39-yard line. It's a gain of 9 yards. And it'll move the chains. He's going to let it fly. And that will be incomplete. As time has run out on this football game. Charles, we saw a lot of points go up in this one. Certainly defensively, stuff that they can look at on film, don't you think?
No doubt about it. And they've got to go back and check where the errors are, how they're going to fix them, and continue to get better at what they do. But they also need a little adjustment with their confidence. To give up that many points, even if you win a game, that can hurt you.
So for the home team here, the win here means it'll be a 7-1 first half of the season. And they'll be able to enjoy this one through the bye week before they get back at it again. Meanwhile, for Dallas, things are kind of getting ugly as they drop to 1-7 now on the year. And they'll take this loss into the bye as they'll be back in action in Week 10. And for Charles Davis and our entire crew here at EA Sports, I'm Brandon Gauden saying so long, everybody.